In the jail, there was a young girl named Ira. I will never forget her. She was about 19. She had blonde hair and was very beautiful. She nursed me when I could not move because of the beatings. In the death chamber, I was tortured. I was given cold showers. I was beaten with leather straps until my skin turned the color of wood. They looked to see if I was circumcised. They used to throw bread down there for us. I was so weak, I could not get any. Ira held me in her arms and protected me from the other prisoners. She saved my bread and fed me. She was half Jewish and a member of the Communist Youth Organization. They took her out of the jail and she never returned. No one ever returned. After I got out of the army, I went back to our house in Radom. At our home, everything looked exactly as if I had left yesterday. Even the furniture, everything in the house was the same. There were just strange people there. I could not stay. I passed through the whole town. Out of 34,000 Jewish people, I could not find even 10 Jewish people left. My older brother, Abe, was the only other born seen to survive the war. He had survived Buchenwald concentration camp and was very sick. He was a broken man. It was hard. I did not recognize him. He was just a broken down man. How do I deal with all of this? By just going to pray. I get up at 5:30 a.m. I go to work. I make myself busy. If I'm not busy, I might end up going crazy. Busy night and day. I remember nothing. Cut it off. Sometimes I try to go back to my past. And it is unbelievable for me.
I was born in Vilna, Lithuania in 1917, the Jerusalem of Eastern Europe. My private hell started 6 months before the war began. In February 1939, I was drafted into the Polish army. The army was the first time that I associated with Poles. We Jews were told, first we are going to take care of the Germans, then we are going to take care of you. How did I feel going against my enemy, the Germans, fighting with my second enemy, the Poles? Vilna at that time was technically located in Lithuania, which was not at war with Germany. I was not classified as a regular Polish soldier, so I was sent to a POW labor camp. This saved my life. The other Jewish soldiers were demobilized and sent back to Poland. There they faced almost certain death. I was separated from my family. They were all killed. This is my Holocaust. After the war, I came to know what happened to some of the members of my family. It is better to know how they died than not know. Near the end of the war, we were marching 2 or 3 days without stopping. The Germans told us to lie down in a field. We slept. The Russian cavalry woke us up. About 30 of them on horses rode up to us. The first thing they said to us was, "I will never forget it. Give us your watches." We learned that they were crazy for wristwatches. We told them who we were, and they left us alone. They smiled and rode away. That was our liberation on April 22, 1945. When the war was over, we thought we had survived because we were smarter than other people. Then we talked to other survivors. Plenty of smart people died. We learned we were just luckier than they were. Somehow, we knew nobody was left alive at home. We did not want to go back to Poland. Eventually, in 1948, I made it to New York. Later, in New Orleans, I got a job as a salesman. In 1981, I went with 37 other Jews to a gathering of Holocaust survivors in Israel. Many people said, "Why didn't we do this before?" The answer was that it took 30 years to heal the wounds before survivors would come. It was just the right time. The whole business with Hitler lasted only 12 years. It started in 1933, and Hitler committed suicide in 1945, which is only 12 years. What is 12 years in history? A blink of an eye.
Wenn wir in der Partei durch unser aller Zutun die höchste Verkörperung des nationalsozialistischen Gedankens und Wesens verwirklichen, wird sie eine ewige und unzerstörbare Säule des deutschen Volkes und Reiches sein, dann wird einst neben die herrliche, ruhmreiche Armee, den alten, stolzen Waffenträger unseres Volkes, die nicht minder traditionsgefestigte politische Führung der Partei treten. Und dann werden diese beiden Einrichtungen gemeinsam den deutschen Menschen erziehen und festigen und auf ihren Schultern tragen, den deutschen Staat, das Deutsche Reich.
I divide Hitler's reign into two parts, 6 years, 1933 to 1939, and 6 years, 1939 to 1945. From 1933 to 39, Hitler was building, 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 and from 1939 to 1945, he was killing, killing, killing.
The Jews and the non-Jews in our town did not mix socially, only in business. The anti-Semitism was very strong. We felt it all over. The Gentile children did not want to associate with us, and they called us names. The Jewish children were not permitted to take part in school plays. People did not believe that the Germans would come until they saw the airplanes. It was so sudden. In a couple of days, the Germans occupied the whole of Poland. Then there was not anything anyone could do. It was too late. Already, it was a fight for survival. We had to do what they wanted. If we did not, we would be killed immediately. We did not have a newspaper or a radio, so we did not know what was going on in the outside world. We just hoped to stay alive and that the war would end before they would do something to us. Even your friends could turn against you. It was as if anyone could pick on the underdog. I did not understand. I felt degraded. There were times when I envied a dog. A dog has his master who takes care of him and feeds him. We were outside the law. Anyone could do with us what they wanted. All the Jews of Olesya and the neighboring villages were moved to the ghetto in Lubasa. The ghetto was the size of one city block for 7,000 people. We slept 28 people in a room that was about 12 by 15 feet. It was like a sardine box. People lived in attics, in basements, in the streets, all over. We were lucky to have a roof over our heads. Not everyone did. The Jewish police helped to find the people in hiding. They had been promised that they would stay alive if they cooperated. I learned later that from my whole city of about 3,000 Jewish families, only 12 people survived. There are times when I ask myself, where was God when my parents were taken away from me? When my youngest brother shouted, which I still hear him screaming, I want to live too. When they took us away, he shouted, I want to live, I want to live. This picture will never, never in my life disappear from my eyes. A lot of times when I lie down, I still hear his voice. He was 3 years old. Even though they were that small, the little children knew what was happening to them. And I asked myself a lot of times, where was God? Where is God?